for that presidential, I'd like to have it. With liquor in his belly, Sonny made up the track. But little did he know that his joints was whack. The shiny A&R said, crank your hitchy. Whenever you need a loop, you'll come get me. The kid got amped and he start to figure, I'ma get told like all of these other niggas. So he's in the studio working round the clock for pop radio. Jack the beat to Planet Rock. Was out in the street where he met his sister, who couldn't sing with shh but the mix with a sister. Hooked up the track in an excitation. He decided he head for the radio station. But he was running and he made a left. Was geezing at top speed and ran into most death. I slowed the young man down and I started running. Yo, why you selling lies to our wives and children? He ran upstairs up to the top floor. Opened up the door there, guess what we saw? Who? Jay the Chicken Head radio host. Who be yapping about between east and west coast. He said he swung a bullet, you got to give it run. The chicken said thanks, just thank the number one. He went outside, was getting props all over. Then he dipped into a ride, the 4.0. Raced up the block, doing 83.3. Some cats were Hennessy, so I'm out of R&D. He winked his eye like his star status matters. They ratted tat tatted to make his blood splatter. You rocking crazy ice and all you do is clean static. And rolling out in Brooklyn late night is problematic. His eyes was bloody red, he hung on every word they said. They told the kid,
back down, the funny shit is dead.
Deep in his heart, he knew he was gone. But he grabbed his 45 and decided to blaze on. But Shane comes down, you had him astounded.
Who's that for?
Before long, the young man got surrounded. Look, grab the gun, so goes the glory. And this is the way I got to end this story. He was out there screaming the American dream, trying to pretend that it's justified the means. This ain't funny, so don't you dare laugh. It just will come to pass when you sell your ass. Life is more than what your hands can grasp.
So you wanna hook your Bluetooth up in here? You wanna hook your Bluetooth up? Get a nice little
yo, bro. What's good with you?
Word, bro. We just starting. Waiting for everybody to come in for real. What's good with you though, bro? I got Lil here next to me. You know Lil, right?
Yeah.
Ron.
Oh yeah.
He said, I ain't going to what's good with you, though, bro? How you holding up? Yeah, I already know, bro. Appreciate it, too. Trying to get these joints back cracking them with the real open mics, yo. Get back a location, man. As soon as we do that, it's be rocking, yo. For real, for real.
She only know me by the
letter.
That's rock and roll shit. I must think I'm
appreciate you checking in too, bro. Word.
That type of shit just get a wetter. She just hope I don't forget her. I told that bitch I would never. Man, I ain't seen that bitch in four ever.
Now you good, bro. Like, usually people don't start jumping in for like 30 minutes. Like, which is crazy. couple years later, here we sipping cold. But you know, as soon as things get off the ground, people gonna come in as soon as this joint send a notification. So just me and my gold niggas. I send you with your homies, couple other hoes with you. They don't even look the type that even roll with you. I see you took your leave out, you got your soul sister. Now the carpet master Drake shouted, I'm just fucking with you. What's up with me and you tonight? Oh, was you walking in and out of my life?
So what?
You know I hate to watch you go. But if you do promise to walk slow. She said that we should talk. What's that for? More, for promo? Like for promotional? Like the brand?
Tonight we should just make love. And tomorrow has to be my day.
What you got playing tonight though, bro? Ron, what you got going on tonight? I was trying to get Lil in the mix out here, while he out here, since he into all the digital work.
I don't know what's gonna happen tomorrow. I don't know what's gonna happen in a week. All I know is tonight, girl.
Peace, peace, Macadon. What's good with you, bro? Good to see you back. Word. Appreciate you checking back in, yo. We gonna start rocking out in about... about maybe 10-15 minutes for real. Brother Keen, what's good with you, bro? Appreciate you checking in too. Oh word, that's where we at, Bowling Run. Yeah, we might have to let me know what's good with that. Text my phone, Ron. Let me know what's good with that. Yeah, what's good with you, Macadon, bro? Hope everything's well on your end up there, up BK. Man, Keno, bless, bro. Just, you know, keeping these things rocking. Just building momentum. You know, it's been a long time come. I've been talking about this for a minute. You know,
fuck, so. Kill, and prosper is the gospel of Wonderland, where street sands are quick to suck you down to the abyss. With the lore of pure bliss, if you kiss the dicks of the niggas, never. Nosferatus, those witches and warlocks.
We're all, that's what's up, bro. You,
keepers of the first
that's zoo. Good. Glad to know you blessed, bro. For real. Maybe. Glad to know everything is well.
I'm the modern day vixen vampire slave. Unauthorized play.
Glad to see you back too, man. If you want, you can start us off since you're the first one in here.
No milk and honey.
Well, we'll wait about like 10 more minutes and then you can start it off for real, for real. So just stay on. Stay on.
Deep into religion was my first decision.
Stay on call.
To save me and my daughter's lives. But I can't thrive off spirit and scripture. The picture grew clearer. I made the move to rear her in a life wanting for nothing. So I got into this drug thing. Not doing, but dealing. Sealing fates and healing struggle gate. Wounds of the doomed became my mission. Ism was just too
word,
small
word.
Time. I had to find the best design.
Let me know if I sound good too, man. Let me know if every the quality is well, the camera's well. You know, audio sounds good. Just let me know. So, you know, I know last time a couple people said it was like flickering and going in and out and kicking us out. So, yeah. Make sure we straight. Give me like 100 sign or, you know, thumbs up if we good.
Silk sheets and money heaps. Still the good mother. I sent my daughter off to boarding school to teach
solid, appreciate it, bro.
All the while envisioning myself a champion of ghetto causes. Cause his game I was playing and winning. While sinning against myself and soul.
I mean, wilding, right?
I was a female dom, the crack queen.
So when he get older, appreciate it, Macadon, yo. Is there anything I can call you for short? I don't want to call it, like, keep saying Macadon. Is Mac cool? Like, I don't want to, you know, disrespect your title. Just let me know what, you know, if Mac is cool. Let me know, bro. I keep saying Macadon, stretching it out. Yeah, I was going on. I said, not right now. He get older, though. He don't have him in the mix. Because he'll be up and walking through, knocking stuff over. All types of shit.
And watched like a side of Shakur.
Mac, word. Alright, Mac, from here on out.
Loose lips,
unless I'm introducing you. You know what I'm saying?
Swiftly ended. It took no time to blend in with the population prison. My jaded vision busted like a cherry. Every dream I had now tainted bad. I fucked and I killed to prosper. Upheld each tenet of the gas.
You know what? Why are we chilling? And since we got some of the realest people in here, I wanted to ask a question. What y'all think about the Vlad TV situation? You know, with them trying to cancel him out and all that they talking about with, like, you know, culture vulture. They trying to cancel people, you know, get them out of the industry now with, you know, the climate we in. What y'all think about that? The ones that's tapped into it, though.
Black prayers and pussy on fire, penned up behind barbed wire. Me and my fellow female mammals, animals, bitches in cages, bodies wrapped with hormone rages, minds haunted by our children's faces. They mace us with promises of rehabilitation / corruption. Play smoking guns in empty hands of
You know Vlad TV, right, Ron? He do all the interviews and whatnot. Pretty much, he said something about, he said, I'm under, okay, well, you know, I just, that's what happens when I scroll. I come across all that. But now, Vlad TV, he pretty much said something about, I'm the only one. This is a whole new situation. Pretty much, Vlad said something about, misquoted Farrakhan, and a couple people had something to say about him, about Vlad, saying, you know, you can't misquote Farrakhan, have respect for the culture if you're going to be in the culture. So it's a whole little thing about that, like, you know, just saying, don't speak on nothing in the culture if you don't respect it, you know, and saying, you know, pretty much that he's just using the culture for what he can get out of it rather than trying to help. Like I said, that's what happens when you scroll, because I typically don't even care for that stuff, honestly. I ain't even know all that. That changes the narrative, you know, if he is Mac, if he is racist, that changes the narrative a lot. But, you know, I mean, you know, they just, he just in it for a paycheck, just like anybody else that's, you know, in it for a paycheck. Using the culture, I guess. That's how I feel. I think we're going to go ahead and get started, though. Might as well start a whole vibe while people come in, right? So, once again, welcome to Vibes for Visionaries. Open mic, open table. It's your boy Jay-Zell. It's Javon Benzel. I'm a hip-hop artist and poet as well. So, like I said, thank y'all for tuning in. Without further ado, we're just going to go ahead and start rocking out. Once again, I thank everybody for being here. And the first artist we will have is Mac. Whenever you're ready, bro. In fact, let me see. I'm going to go ahead and send you the request now.
Yo, yo. Peace, King. What's good with you?
What's going on, man? How are you?
All is well, bro. All is well, man. Like I said, I'm glad to have you back, bro. And if you want to just let the people know who you are and your realm of art and consciousness and what you want to bring to us.
Okay. I go by the name of Macadon Blackheart. So I'm from Brooklyn, New York. So I'm going. I just recently finished something new, so I'm gonna do that. So in light of Breonna Taylor's story, like when it first started, I had nothing like to artistically offer.
Right.
And just overall, when this whole thing, like, not even just her, but like. Overall, when the initial protest started, when George Floyd happened,
mm-hmm.
and all that started, I was like one of many people. I can't say many. Let me just speak for myself. I had nothing to offer while all of that was going on.
Right.
And so I finally got into a moment where I was able to finally write something. So, and it happens to be, it happens to follow like, I don't know how, maybe 2, 3, 4 days after they got like they heard the results of the case, of her case, where right. they was going to charge, and it turned out they're not being charged pretty much for killing her.
Right.
So. But this, what I came up with is, this is pretty much, for lack of a better term, a alternative timeline of like what it would be like if she did not get killed that night. What if that night wasn't your last? You sleep peacefully until morning comes into grasp onto your spirit, making you rise and shine. As your man kisses your gold and his eyes align with yours, another day to go get it. You make way to your job with positive intentions for a good day. Showered by your man with the loving things he would say, navigating through different kinds of energy. But you're a people's champ, a light-emitting entity. I personally feel hospitals aren't good to work in. It's a place for people who are hurting, and in most cases, if you're hurting, you ain't happy. The rare cases, as a masochist, how that be? Now, wait a second. Not even thinking. See, you're not even a nurse. You're an EMT. Let me get back to you. I'm messing up. Uninspired illness like, don't press your luck. Just when you're about to call it a night, you're back out responding to a distress call. Pull up. A home was invaded. Woman shot in her sleep. A man in tears saying she was shot by police. Your team gets to her. Identifies what's possible. Only ones actually did what is their job to do. A shock to him and just as much shock to you. Her eyes open. Revived hope in a moment of random injustice. Even if the only good thing literally is just this. A life almost lost to you gave you help. Hidden poetic justice, you just saved yourself. Fast forward to her being back to her normal self. Recovery phase complete, all is well. She pays a visit to your workplace. Her smile a bit bigger than that on your face. In perfect timing too, you're on your break. Y'all chat and she invites you to come to her place. You agree to it. It's a sure date. You and your man, her and her folks, cherishing life with love, corny jokes, rich drinks and full plates. On an ice cube tip. Today was a good day. As if you didn't already have some good cake, news reports them officers are being put away. Look at God. Need I say more? Working hard like you, but no days off. Transition to the officer behind a bullet. Gotta keep an eye sharp behind him looking. He's in worst case scenario. He thought being a cop was scary though. How sharing the same roof with men low as you, but they're Breonna skin criminals. And COs ain't EMTs. They can care less to see you breathe. So, shall you come face to face with death? Pray to God for the skills to save yourself.
So,
I finally came up with something for that. I gotta work on that though, because like I said, it's new.
No, I definitely felt that though, bro. I take it that because of the killers being acquitted, that's what brought it out of you. That's what gave you the energy to speak on it.
Two things. I can't say exactly that because when I heard it, it didn't come to me at that moment.
Right.
Two things helped me find words for it. One, some random, I can't say a random live, but it was a live I was on two nights ago. And the person doing the live kind of like did it in the style of like a workshop.
Right.
We had like certain words we had to use to write a poem. And the certain words that was offered, it made me think of like, it made me think of Breonna Taylor in the situation, right?
Mm-hmm.
And in that same thought process, I also thought about a Lupe Fiasco song.
Mm-hmm.
And the style that Lupe Fiasco song is written is kind of like the song is written giving life to a child that was killed by gun violence.
Mm-hmm.
And the child is young, right? So they didn't even get to live, right?
Right.
So what Lupe did in that song is he pretty much creates a whole timeline for her where she does grow up.
Right.
And she becomes this sort of like a doctor that works in a clinic in her neighborhood. And she ends up coming across a situation where she saves this girl who in turn ends up being herself.
Wow.
So that's
What's that song called?
Janala Forever.
Janala Forever. I think I did hear it a while back. I mean, I'm going to definitely check it out, though, because I'm sure it resonates heavy with all that's going on. Yeah, I'm going to definitely check that out. Yeah, so my fault. I didn't mean to cut you off, but go ahead.
That's all good.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, that song and the live that I joined where we had to like use words to write a poem, because mm-hmm. I tried to include those words in what I wrote. I include all of them. I did like two, but that's how I came up with that poem.
Yeah.
So I'm practicing it, which is why I'm pretty much sharing this on almost every live I join right now, to be honest with you.
True. Yeah. Definitely felt it, bro. Definitely felt it. And that's crazy. Like, I like how you took us into the next day. You know what I mean? Like, you just took us into her simply. I mean, the situation's messed up how, you know, it went down. I don't even like thinking about it. But, you know, just the way that you broke it down definitely made it more. How can I say this? It made it more, I guess, I want to say emotional, but not emotional. That's not the word I'm looking for. It really brought it out, though. You know what I'm saying? Like, it just made envision it in a way that, you know, that it just, it touched your soul in a way that you can envision it. That's the way I'm trying to say. You know what I mean? And,
thank you.
Yeah. For sure.
My goal was to, like, pretty much continue. Like I said, it's just a different timeline where she doesn't randomly get killed, and she right. like, remember, she's in her house and she just randomly get killed in her own house. So what I did was, like I said, it's inspired by a Lupe Fiasco song, so I took that same concept and like put her in a position where she does live the next day, but right. she encounters that same situation and someone else who in turn pretty much ends up being herself.
Right.
So she saves herself from dying.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, right. Yeah, man.
And then like afterwards they like the what grows from that situation, from her saving herself, and pretty much like the idea of like gratitude and love and appreciation for life,
the things that we need.
What I did to follow that up,
right?
Definitely. And also like the justice that we all wanted, but we kind of knew wasn't gonna happen. Mm-hmm. All of us are being indicted,
right?
And being in a situation where what you gonna do now when you in a facility that's African American dominated?
Mm-hmm.
Like if you thought being a cop was scary, mm-hmm. imagine being in jail, being a prison full of the same people you scared of.
Right. Right. They ain't think about that though.
Word.
Yeah, that's true though.
So yeah, just overall try to I want to like I said, I took that inspiration from Lupe Fiasco and gave her a happy ending.
Yeah, it's definitely. And I also like how you switch that around, because it does leave anybody that hears it, I feel like it'll leave the situation on a more lighter note. You know what I mean? And that's what we need also is to, I mean, yeah, we got to be aware of what's going on and, you know, definitely fight for what needs to be fought for. But I do like how you embodied that. And it does leave a positive, you know, a positive or, you know, around the situation. So, yeah, for sure. For sure.
Thank you, man.
Thank you.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, if you ask anything else, bro, I mean, I want to leave the table open for you if you got anything else that you want to give to us. You know?
I'll end it like this. Right now, it's for you to understand me. Plan A is to win your heart. Won't need a plan B. After this, my art will live in your heart like family. If you walk within my march, you're officially a black heart, but understand what the name represents. It represents the everyday battle between dark and light, the clash between black and white, but do know that black isn't necessarily dark and white isn't necessarily light. Most importantly, the battle within oneself, but doesn't break you altogether during your healing will make you better. I can do all things through God who strengthens me. With God strengthen me, I will build bridges for those on the edge, cut nooses, turning people into blue-faced rednecks.
Mm.
When the chips are down, I'm the best bet. And until I'm laid to rest, no being some is their own death yet. That's why I speak to reawaken, because that's how I define inspiration. And now you know the name. Shall you never forget it? I am. You are. We are the most inspiring artist alive, Macadon Blackheart.
Peace.
Love, my man.
Peace. Appreciate you, bro. Word.
100.
Word. Shout out to Mac, yo. Shout out to the boy, Mac. Man, blessed us with that. The first piece, I ain't gonna lie, man. It just because we're in that time now, it hit hard and it hit home. And yeah, shout out to Mac for that. And the second one, of course, yo, we had him last show and he did his thing. Like, it was good to have him back. Great to have him back. So yeah, man, shout out to Mac for them two pieces. But if we got any other artists, the floor is open. You know what I'm saying? I see shout out everybody that just came in. Like I said, my name is Javon Benzel, aka J Zells. Welcome to Vibes for Visionaries Open Mic and Open Table. I am the host. I am also a hip hop artist and poet. So you can check out my work on my personal page at Javon Benzel. Or yeah, if you type in Javon Benzel on Instagram search, it should pop up with no problem. So yeah, man. If we got anybody who wants to perform, like if you want to bring any content to the table, because that's what this is about, bringing your content and creating conversation, you know. So if you have anything that you feel heavy on your heart, you want feedback from the audience, you want just even talk about something, the floor is open. The floor is open. So Oh, I see we got an artist that sent a request. I'm sorry, Queen. I missed that. I got you. Let's see. My apologies, Queen. I'm in the midst of talking and everything. I didn't even see it.
Hi.
Peace, peace. How you?
Good. You're fine. IG's been back on its bullshit, so I wasn't sure if my request just didn't go through, or I was like, right. Is it one?
No. Yeah, I didn't see it, but it's all good. We're here now. So
one second, my light is off and it's like terrible.
Go ahead and turn the music down.
There we go.
Now you're all good, yep. Ugh. How's everything with you on your end?
Better now that it's the weekend and my child is in bed. Better.
Right.
Better. Well, than you know, it was.
Yeah. Well, I mean, that's, yeah.
Oh, let's hear a freestyle. I don't think I am awake enough for that shit right now.
Yeah, I don't know who he was direct. That's actually my cousin. He probably was over here talking to me. Didn't realize we was going live.
Does that mean I don't know. Let me specify my shit first and then we'll talk.
Yeah, we can get a cypher going if that's, you know, get a freestyle thing going on.
We'll see. Let me get in a rhythm. So I always say there are like three sides to Cynical Insomniac, which is me. Hello, I'm Cynical Insomniac. I have a yes, sir. I really like that intro piece, Magadon. It was today your extra piece, but the intro piece, that was nice. I like the flow on that. That was very nice. Hard hitting, slap you in the face, political. Deep. Slightly dark pieces, or super dark, depending, and then fun, like, you know, bop your head. I want to do it at least, if you've got time, one political and one fun, if that's cool.
Definitely. Most definitely.
Where do you want to start? Slap you in the face or fun?
We'll do slap you in the face first, and then we'll leave off on the fun note.
Okay, let's do one I haven't read much. I've only read it, I think, in one other live. So I'm not sure how smooth it's going to be.
Take your time.
Heads up. It's called 1,000 to 1. You say it's okay to protest, but peacefully. Not with fires, though, because that's rioting. Okay. How about quietly? For example, with LeBron's I Can't Breathe t-shirt. No? That's too disquieting. What did Laura Ingraham say? Oh, that's right. Shut up and dribble. What about Kaepernick kneeling? It's quiet, it's subtle, but that, you said, is unpatriotic and somehow belittles the troops and disrespects the flag when all it's meant to do is draw attention to the number of Black people ending up in body bags. What about white protesters with guns? You said that's, wait, that's okay? They had assault rifles on federal grounds in the Michigan State House with zero consequences and zero judgment. That's peaceful to you? I'd call the majority of BLM marches peaceful, but if these people were brandishing guns, they'd get way more than rubber bullets thrown their way, 1,000 to 1. And the police response proves my point. The armed white men, the ones in Michigan, they were in the cops' faces shouting and cursing, and the cops were stoic. No retribution, no reaction. After all, these men were just practicing their freedoms. There's no need to take action. Then there's us. Multiple examples of things like protesters walking away from the cops with their hands in the air, getting sprayed with pepper spray because they broke the curfew, so really it's their fault that they were there. How can anyone look at these examples of the dichotomy of police response outside the framework of politics and race? This is countrywide. It's not geographically specific. We can't look at this on a case-by-case basis, and they know they are being filmed. Yet they feel so comfortable and confident of the fact that there will be zero accountability, that they will shove an old man so hard that he falls back and cracks his head open on the concrete. They will walk by as he bleeds. Then they'll put out a statement saying that he tripped and fell. They'll pull a man off his bike and beat the hell out of him with their batons. They'll tackle a black man who's giving an interview to reporters on the street, coming up from behind him with guns drawn. They know they're being filmed. And they just don't care. That should tell us something very important about the state of our law enforcement system today. Our cops have free rein, and they know it. And they want to keep it that way. That's that piece.
Thank you. Yes. And it's crazy that you said, like, I like how you started it out speaking on, like, a lot of the peaceful protests that have been done. I mean, as of recently, and, you know.
Shut up, you're right.
And then it's like, damned if you do, damned if you don't, you know. And,
yeah,
I love how you put that together. I really do. And I appreciate the words that you put, you know, especially hearing it from you. You know, when we need all colors, everybody on board, you know.
I want to do the fun one, but I've got one more political one that I really like.
Most definitely. You want to take, you can do both of them.
Are you sure?
I say, well, we got about 5 to 10 minutes per guest. So if you want to do whichever one.
The fun one is super short. So I'll do, I'll just do both.
That's fine.
I'll do the other political one now and still end with the fun one. This is worth of our words. Kind of goes to what we were talking about how it's fucking sad that coming out of a face like mine, it means more, but fine. Worth of our words. Someone recently told me they believe the Black Lives Matter movement wanted to apologize for people being white. That's insane. That's propaganda. They want us to understand, and we can try, but we can't. Not really. But we can care, and we can be there if they need us. We can use our voice to fight for their cause when their voice doesn't have the same impact as ours. We can be silent when need be. So the only voice heard is theirs. We can get arrested with them and pepper sprayed with them and even shot with rubber bullets. But if we can't be on the street, we can write. We can read. We can be informed and know what the fuck we're talking about when we open our mouths. So if you're like me and you can't be in the crowds, you can still help. You can still have a voice. You can still tell these racists to fuck off. You still have a choice between right and wrong. This outrageous oppression has gone on far too long. These murders, not deaths, not accidental murder by a cop, but murders, happen far too often. It's not coincidental. We're almost used to it. We see a news banner on our phone, unarmed black man shot by police. We swipe to the left without reading it. We cannot become numb to it. It's horrific every single time it happens. And maybe that's why we swipe it away. But that's not an excuse either. Because if that were your father or your brother or your sister, would you want someone to ignore their story? Would you want someone to shrug it away and say, another black person dead another day? We cannot let this become normal. Or I guess we can't continue letting this be normal. It's not. It can't be. It's time to fight back. And how we're doing it now, not the fires, the looting, the shit the right wing is advertising as the goals of the movement, but consistent remembrance and saying their names is exactly the right thing to do to bring about change. We have to keep going. We have to keep moving. We have to keep writing. We have to keep proving the worth of our words, the worth of Black lives. It's sad that that's something that we have to prove, but that's where we are. That's our reality. Well, it's not my reality from my privileged position as a pale redhead in grad school with paid tuition, but this is the reality of every Black person in this country on a daily basis. They have to prove the worth of their existence, and all we have to do is be there. All we have to do is recognize their pain, and don't say you understand because you don't. I don't. We never will, but that should not stop us from trying to help, from trying to kill the source of the pain, and we have to keep fighting. Keep going, keep speaking. Even on your darkest day, pick up your pen and keep writing.
Thank you for that. Most definitely. And I appreciate you being, you know, supportive, you know, through these times, because, you know, as tough as it is, as much as, you know, it seems to be repetitive, like you said, you become numb to it, but it's, you gotta be careful. Yeah.
I say this every time I spit one of those poems. It's like, if all I can do is like angrily write at 2 a.m. and then shout into a phone, I will. Okay, fine.
For sure.
I'll do it. Let me do this one real fast. I don't want to take up too much time. Let's end on a high note. I love this one. It's fun. It's called Facts. Let's go.
Thank you.
To hear ourselves talk. Yes, we're creative, but we're also a little arrogant. And yeah, sometimes we're brave when we spit something vulnerable or controversial that we really believe in, something that speaks to our soul. But at the bottom of it, we also just kind of like the spotlight. We like the echo our voice makes in a room, whether empty or full. Of course, full is preferred. We like when we can create a rhythm in a piece. When we can move our head to a beat, move our hands, plant our feet, play with our voice deeper, sweet, sway our hips, let our eyes slide side to side, keeping the audience alive, gasping in sips of breath through their teeth, snapping their fingers all the while. That feedback moves our blood. It makes our heart beat faster. And yes, we're speaking truth and we're doing it for you just as much as we're doing it for us. But I'm just being honest here. That feedback hypes us up. What we do, this particular art form is not necessarily widely appreciated or even widely accepted, at least in my little corner of the world. So when it gets supported, we get excited. When we find each other in this big, mean world, we stick together. Yeah, we talk big, we talk shit, we get competitive. Yeah, it's called slam poetry for a reason. But if any single one of us needs any single thing in any single season, we will be there, even if we have never met, except through a tiny mobile screen from different time zones across oceans. If one of us screams for help, we will be there. If one of us experiences pain and expresses it through words, someone across the world will read those words or hear those words and cry with us at the same time. They'll send hearts and hugs, taking time out of their day to make sure that they can have a positive effect on yours. So yeah, we like to hear ourselves talk. And yes, we're creative, even brilliant sometimes. And could you guess we're just a tiny bit arrogant? I guess what I'm saying is recognize all that and just don't take it for granted.
Most definitely.
Thank you for the platform, my good sir.
Thank you for joining us. And yeah, if you you want to plug us in with your information, what's your name again? I didn't get your name at the beginning.
Cynical_insomniac. Gotcha. Name's Kathy. Cynical Insomniac. Yeah,
okay. Most definitely. All right. Well, appreciate having you and thank us for your wonderful work. Definitely engaging and look forward to having you back.
Thank you. I will be back. Thank you, sir. Bye.
Most definitely. Be safe. Shout out to Cynical Insomniac for giving us those words. You know, the first two, you know, she definitely, touched on what was going on. And, you know, we need people of all shades, you know, to give their piece and they take from their from their perspective, you know, it's always needed. So, and, you know, despite what's going on, she did end us off on a very light note as well. So appreciate you, Miss Cynical Insomniac. So, yeah, once again, for everybody that has joined us, welcome to Vibes for Visionaries live open mic, open table. My name is Javon Benzel. For those of you that have not met me, a.k.a. Jay Zells, hip-hop artist, poet. You can find my book on Amazon. I'm going to plug myself in right now if y'all don't mind me do that. You can find my stuff on Amazon and Kindle. That's Javon Benzel. It's called Whether You Read This or Not, my self-published book right here, Whether You Read This or Not, now available on Amazon and Kindle. And, you know, yeah, man, I'll do some work at the end of it, you know, at the end after everybody else is done. So right now, if we got anybody else that wants to bless us. Oh, okay. I see you. Say the poet. Let me see. Say the poet. If you still ain't here, we're going to rock.
Mm-hmm. Yo.
Hello. Peace, peace.
Can you hear me? Hello, hello.
Yep, yep.
Yeah, my name is, I'm good. I'm doing
it's
good.
Breaking
my
up.
Name is Huh? Can you hear me?
It's breaking up. You're like in and out.
Alright. Is it better now?
Yeah, yep, it looks like you everything's still, so you good.
If y'all can hear
Tay the Poet, if y'all can hear Tay the Poet, give us a thumbs up if he's looking good. Yeah, on my end you look like it's a little jumpy, but for the most part it's looking all right.
All right, so my name's Tayshawn, aka Tay the Poet O3. And I got this one I'm working on. I'm not all the way finished with it, but I'll just show you what I have and then you can see what you think. No, I'm not a comedian, though I crack jokes like a code on crack that reacted broken, open to emotions I'm showing, hoping you catch a line that affects you spine, as if poets' lyrics were punchlines you laugh at every time, like a comedy show. Under me when I go, I draw crowds without a pencil. That's what I got so far. I'm not really sure what else to add to it, but that's what I got so far.
Okay. Okay, are you a rapper as well?
Yeah, I do a little bit of both. I'm mostly a poet though. I mostly consider myself a poet because a lot of people say, you know, I'm a better poet than a rapper. And I believe that, so I just go with poetry, spoken word.
If you don't mind, let's hear that one again, man. Cause I didn't know you were gonna end off like just like that, like. But nah, you can you're breaking up just a little bit. So if you want to do that one more time.
All right. Mm-hmm. No, I'm not a comedian though. I crack jokes like a code on crack that we react and broke and open to emotions. I'm showing, hoping you catch a line that affects your spine, as if poets' lyrics were punchlines. You laugh at every time like a comedy show. Under me when I go, I draw crowds without a pencil.
Word. Yeah, I heard that. Yeah, most definitely.
Yeah. Word. Hey, can I do another one? Do you mind if I do another one?
That's fine, bro. I mean, you literally have like 5 to 10 minutes, like, so you straight, man. Whatever you got, get off your chest.
All right, this one's called Black Excellence. I wrote this a few days ago, or maybe like it's last week. I really don't remember. The excellence of black men and women has been within our DNA even during slavery days. Those weapons were preparation to toughen us up. They bound us with chains until we were strong enough. They hid books making us curious to look. The truth shall set you emancipated. Why you think Booker T walked 500 miles just to make it? Then in 1875, he graduated. In 1881, he founded his own college. What's excellence without knowledge? Fast forward when Nipsey was banged in 60s and became an entrepreneur. Snoop went from being a shooter to a recruiter, recruiting youth to the fields out the streets so they don't get killed. Now, homie, chill. You can succeed, make $1 billion like Tyler Perry or Jay-Z. Stop being lazy.
Okay.
Pay the part up. Yeah.
Appreciate you, King. That's most important.
Hey, thank you.
Yep. And let us know where they can find you, if we can find more of your work. You got anything that's available for us to check out?
You can check my page out on Tay the Poet 03 and I can type it in for you. And I'm on the radio. One of my friends, you know, he got his own radio station, so I'm on the radio from time to time.
Okay.
And I'm working on a book, but I don't know. It's my first time making a book, so I'm kind of like struggling with the process, but I know God got me, so that's when you're taking care of regardless. So.
Bro, DM me, and I can give you some information, like at least what I know. I did it a certain way, but, you know, I had to go under doing it. So, yeah, I could definitely plug you in on something that I might know that might be of help.
All right.
So, yeah, DM me and let me know, bro, whatever you need.
All right, I will do that. All right, thanks for having me on.
Appreciate having you, King. Stay up.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Was definitely shout out to Tay the Poet. Gave us them bars, like, yo, he's talking about, yo, we gotta get on our entrepreneurship, you know, especially in these times, man. I keep saying that in these times, but it's crazy out here. So, you know, we got to definitely make sure that we are taking care of ours, you know what I'm saying? And get up and get out. So, shout out to Tater Poet once again. I see we had another request. I'm trying to get you in there. Or appreciate everybody checking in too as well. Vibes for Visionaries, open mic, open table, discussion. Let's get it.
Hello.
Hello, Peace Queen. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
Doing great, doing great. Glad to have you. If you want to plug us in with who you are, where you're hailing from, and what you will be blessing us with.
Okay. So my name is Mama Mist. I am a poet, singer, songwriter, lyricist, actress, historian, and I'm also a spiritual reader and healer. So okay. That's just a little bit of what I do. Right. I guess I'm from Gary, Indiana. Let me stop. I'm going to go ahead and give you this little intro.
You're breaking up just a little
bit. My name is Mama Miss. I'm from Gary, Indiana, better known as the G. Can't forget the I right next to the shy. Yeah. Currently in the Queen City where we get real shy litty.
Mm-hmm.
So, right. Hope I give you a little taste of what's going on. Say your name one more time for me.
You said my name?
Yeah.
Javon Benzel. J-A-V-O-N Benzel. It's like Denzel with a B. That's how I explain it.
Where you at? Where you located?
I am in Newcastle, Delaware. That's like about 30 minutes from Philly. 30 minutes from Philadelphia.
Okay.
30 minutes south of Philadelphia. And about an hour north of Baltimore. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Yup, a little small.
You affiliated with Dr. Umar?
No, I wouldn't say that. Why? Because of Philly?
Okay, I just want to ask. I'm like, let me make sure, because, you know, he's from Philly. He got a school in Delaware. I'm like, yeah.
No, we've crossed paths, but no, I wouldn't say affiliated. Like, you know, I wouldn't claim that, you know.
Right, I get you.
For sure. Mm-hmm.
Cool. So, this is my first time meeting you. I'm going to do this piece. It's called 80s Baby. I don't know if you're an 80s baby, 90s baby, whatever.
Early,
but hopefully you feeling
just
it.
Just missed it. Yep.
You say what?
I said early 90s. Just missed that boat.
I get you.
Yep.
So, my name is Samantha. 80s baby. Sitcom friendly. Complacent lady. Happy-go-lucky, more my buddy than Chucky. Giggling, joyous, and chubby. Problem solved in 30. Mood on up, too good to get dirty. Bobby McFerrin, be happy, don't worry. You know, I'm your all-American star. But I'm his story and her story and their story. I'm talking all of those Negroes from Dancing with Wolves and Glory. I am for everyone. Not for everybody. Not so much Wham, but more like Lottie Dottie. More like Hill City Black. Beans and cornbread every day was called eating hearty. Like, I'm so Midwest. But no, my blood was bred in Mississippi super slaves. Only the best of the best. The real supermen and wonder women who bore another's name on their chest. They were the first stock Americans would invest. Like my dad played with Emmett Till. But I should keep quiet when another innocent black child is killed. Wait. But I am an 80s baby. I am ODB's and Mariah's fantasy. I am a reading rainbow butterfly in the sky. I know I can fly twice as high. But I am summertime. and the living is easy. Fish are jumping, and the cotton is high, high. But I am an 80s baby. A Lady Holiday. Maybe I'm more than just an 80s baby. Maybe I'm my ancestors' baby. Maybe I am their Superman and Wonder Lady. Maybe. 80s baby.
Hey. I like that. I like how you're taking us through so many different emotions there and like different just quotes, for sure. For sure.
Well, thank you. I'm glad you like that. I wrote that the first time I ever saw Blues perform down here in Charlotte. I don't know if you know him, but he's a widely known poet. He done like commercials for Charlotte Hornets and stuff like that.
Okay.
I was like, let's see. I got another piece I can do for you. You want light or you want deep?
Let's do deep, because the first one was a little light. Let's see. Yeah, for sure. Let's expand the spectrum.
Okay. Let's go. Quote Nair story. So, y'all still quote Nair story for your story. Won't even listen to your own kin about where you come from and where you been. I share because I love you and want you to be more positive. But my efforts seem like throwing gems to pigs. You let some folks that ain't ever been nowhere tell you where you been. Let the global minority claim they're the majority, make you call that speck of land they come from a continent. How is it three continents when they all connected? Colored people, indigenous around the world, but they want you to feel like a reject. Tell you you're from Africa, but they're a 15-minute boat ride away. And y'all respect that? Why don't you tell them to leave you alone? Tell them to go back to Africa. You already are home. All over the earth, colored people got seniority. So how is the baby of humanity the world's authority? This terrible two, oil spilling his sippy cup everywhere, stealing your toys, making a mess, and forcing you to clean it up. Barely can read himself, but grading you on how you read his book. Trading in your spiritual lineage for his translation of a holy book. Drink he gave, hand you shook. Woke up from your hangover to find your story, traditions, sexuality, and land were took. Convinced you came here in boats and chains because of one painting, copied and pasted in a bunch of books. 100 million people enslaved, they say, but where are the boats and chains? If it was that many people moved, then there were boats and chains that would remain.
Right.
Stole everything they could touch, but you claim to be the real cooks. Got you claiming to be black, because to them it means the dead. Well, you can see your true colors if you took another look. And every 20 years, you're called something else, because they took another look. It's called paper genocide, but you won't find that in no school books. This piece of land got its own voice. We sing its song, and they say, we got soul. You're the same color of this land, but they've convinced you you're not home or whole. Place bets on you and put it on the books. Now, if that's justice, that's one crazy ass hook. That's that piece.
Definitely. Now, can I ask you a question? Do you,
yes, sir.
Were you always, I don't want to use the term, forgive me for using this term, but woke? Or were you, do you recall always being conscious, of like, were you given that upbringing? Like, despite,
It was something in me.
Mm-hmm.
I was, so I grew up Jehovah's Witness, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so we didn't celebrate birthdays and holidays. I could like go without doing Halloween, Christmas, all the good stuff. But when they got ready to do the Black History program, because it was Black History and then it changed to African American history while I was in school.
Right.
I would get in trouble for singing the Negro spiritual anthem. You know what I'm saying? So
hold on, not to interrupt you, Queen.
Always been in me.
Not to interrupt you, Queen, but it's about to